So you need to have something you believe in, a cause, an impact that you can have, and then if stars align and you have an idea or a product, you can be an entrepreneur. My name is Maya Pindeus. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Humanising Autonomy. We are a UK-based computer vision company enabling any machine to understand and interpret human behavior. I would say I grew up in a family that really valued knowledge, culture and arts. I think that's the main thing for me. So my parents always encouraged me, play music, be artistic, go to exhibitions, make sure to explore the artistic side and read a lot. I want to be a doctor at some point, like a surgeon, but I'm very clumsy, so I'm very happy I actually didn't go for this. I studied architecture in Vienna at the University of Applied Arts. My plan was to study architecture but never be an architect. Although I loved the studies. It's one of these where you can do so much when you have the education, because you can touch into fashion, into graphic design, into product design, engineering, biology, anything really. While doing my studies, I got really interested in the robotics element. So I went into industrial and product design and started collaborating with a friend around installations. We created a makeup robot that would interact with your face, and actually the fun or the interaction would happen when people approach this robot. It's really a robot that would paint your face. But it's kind of these magical moments that you create. I want to create things, definitely. It definitely wasn't clear that I want to be a founder or CEO, whatever it may be. It was more I want to work independently and explore independently or in a collective with people. This always fascinated me about how are we going to interact with those machines, whatever machines may be, right? Is it your makeup robot, or is it your hairdryer? Is it a car, or is it, you know, your handheld device? It was 2016, 17. Everyone was talking about AI. Everyone was talking about self-driving cars, robots, and they were sure that it was only a few years until the streets will be populated with them. And they were also sure that everything is solved or on the way of being solved, but no one was talking about people. And that sounded really, really wrong. And so that led us to explore it a bit more, and we started building prototypes around how would a machine interact with you and you with a machine. So we trained a little AI model to recognize gestures, and we created an interface that would respond to you. So at the beginning, we were students who built a prototype, and we were like exploring where this should go. And we're like, well, there's something there, 100%. And obviously, there's the societal impact, that's the conviction that we have. So let's just go for it. And we went to San Francisco for a couple months. 2 months later, we're like, OK, fine, we'll just register the company and go for it. Vision machine, human machine interaction will touch every day, or is already touching kind of every point of our life. From the moment we get up to the moment we go to work, we, you know, we are at work, we go on holidays, all of the things. The way we build a company is to create technology for people, built around people, and it is ethical at its core. We have a range of production deals where actual cars or driver assistance systems and other like dash cams are devices that are actually building our software into their products. For instance, you're driving through Vienna and there's loads of cyclists, loads of pedestrians, but who is actually looking to cross the path of you? Who is likely to be a hazard? Who is likely to make a U-turn? All of those things. You need to infer, so is there a likely risk? What is the likely experience that the driver will have, and so on. So that's actually on the road, which is really, really cool. And in parallel, we started kind of going back to our original mission. We want to be an enabler for human-machine interaction. So we started working in a smart home, mixed reality, and metaverse, which has been hugely exciting. We've grown it to about 50 people, based out of London, quite distributed across Europe, and a small team in Japan as well. In the very beginning, it was about, that's really cool, but would anyone need that? Now, 5 years later, it's like, oh, people are so complex. How can you actually do that? It really comes down to, I would call it background diversity and a multidisciplinary mindset, to use the word. We have designers, engineers, psychologists, artists, and so on, all working together. So I think it requires this representation of, I guess, of society in order to make something that's truly innovative. Don't think that everything will be just robotic like a 90s sci-fi, right? I do believe that autonomous car will come eventually. I do believe that the supply chain will be much more efficient, much better. I do hope that we use our resources more effectively. You could call it a bold decision to start a company. You could do that. You can call it a bold decision to change career completely, to go into the unknown. But I don't think there was a massive, big dramatic inflection point at any point. I think it's a series of small things. So I wouldn't call it an entrepreneurial mindset, but a mindset of curiosity from, you know, enough from architecture, let's go into arts, let's go into design, let's go into engineering. And it's a sequence of things.